So today was an amazing day. Let me show you what exactly happened today. Good afternoon YouTube, this is Rahil and this is definitely not Rage. Speaking of Rage, yes, Augie F is in Bangalore and I am going to meet him. So Augie has come to Bangalore as a part of the iconic ride by IBW, that is Indian Bike Week, that is happening very soon. All the bikers have come over, they are assembling the bikes over here and we all are waiting for OGF at the moment. He hasn't come yet, so we just saw OGF near the signal. The signal have just left and I guess is approaching the petrol bunk now, so let's wait and watch what happens. It's coming. Yes, Augie F is over here. As you can see, so many bikers have turned up and all are heading to McDonald's upstairs. As Augie F has arrived, it's so awesome to meet him in Bangalore. So Augie F meetup, it was so amazing. I also got to meet so many YouTubers today, including Big Bang Biker, Rishabh Chatterjee, Bullet Diaries. I'm sorry if I've forgotten some names. Namma Bengaluru Logs. Excuse me. So it was amazing, the day was awesome, the arrangements were so good, we also got so many goodies. We got a t-shirt, a keychain, cap from Seat, who are sponsoring Augie F. And Augie F is an amazing person, gives high preference on safety of riders and that's a very good thing. So guys, ride safe, wear helmet, ride all the necessary riding gear. Oh, forgive me, I don't have gloves today as my friend has borrowed it. So yeah.
Welcome to this gathering and over to our friend Augie. Firstly, I just want to thank all of you guys for taking the time today. I know it's a working day. How many of you are working? Like, technically supposed to be working today. Your managers aren't watching these videos, I hope. Okay. Try and make it fast. I went to Goa as well towards the end of last year and I unfortunately had to have a meetup on a working day as well. While the turnout was good over there, I think the turnout's better over here, so give yourselves a round of applause. Thank you so much for taking our time. I just want to, I know I probably all of you would not suddenly watch my videos and have seen most of them, but I think the culture, the biking culture in Bangalore is something I'm really amazed by. Because the moment I crossed borders and came into your state, I realized there's a lot of responsibility and ownership on safety amongst your riders themselves, which is not something we really see a lot of in Mumbai, and especially in where I live in Bangalore. When it comes to SIAT as well and to the tire park also, I know just like he said, they've got a lot of branches around this area itself, and looking at some of the brands they've got on board, we could really use something like that where I live. Because I was struggling to get some tires for my RC390 when the tires actually worn out. I think it's wonderful that we have establishments which cater to multiple brands. What we are is a bit starved for choice in India when it comes to tires. I get so many questions from you, especially from one of those older videos I did about changing tires on my R15. Like a lot of people ask me, hey, I got this tire, what do I do? What tire do I put for this bike? Or will so and so tire fit into this motorcycle's rim? And when you have professionals like this who have tires of multiple brands under one roof, I think it becomes easier for you to come in and not just get your tires but also get consultation in terms of which tires will suit. And I think it's a great way to start promoting the right choice in making decisions.
I also asked Doggy a few questions and he answered them so nicely. Here's the clip of me asking him questions and him answering.
But if you have any questions, and I know this is usually the moment that you need to go silent and ask for that question, but if you have any questions for me about what I'm doing here and any other thing I'll tell you about, so then answer your question. What are the questions we have?
How dynamic are you feeling in the most dynamic city of the world?
I think. Actually, I was just telling my friends, I called up one of my friends earlier and he asked me how are you feeling about this thing in Bangalore. To be honest, I was told that there's a lot of traffic, which there is.
It's a bigger jungle out here.
It's a bigger jungle. Yeah, there's no ambition. But where I live in Bandra, most people come on their weekends to kind of party or visit these celebrities, how we have Salman Khan or Shah Rukh Khan, and our place is always packed over the weekend. So for me, riding through so much traffic isn't that much of a stress in our life. But I think the way people ride around is a little different from what I'm used to in Mumbai. Because in Mumbai, there's still a bit of etiquette left when you're in a lane and you're moving still. But here, I think you just kind of like something like that. I don't know if you'll have a term for that.
They just
keep on doing that. And I think it's because of the bike I'm on, some people just want to prove that they're better than me, and I let them have that as long as my bike is not damaged. But yeah, I think that's the main change I've seen. But what I like is that people stay behind the line here. I noticed that quite a bit of the signals, at least around this area where it's staying. People follow the traffic. And you're looking surprised right now, that's not the case.
Yeah,
see, that's not around the case. But it's more than what you see in Mumbai. So okay. In that way, it happens.
And
we have Big Bang bikers.
Yeah. So.
Hey, what other questions?
So one more question. How do you balance your work life with your YouTubing life?
No, but honestly, I get a lot of support from my family and from my work, from my manager as well. So pretty much everyone at work has an OBM sticker at their desk right now because they've all subscribed from one person to the other. I think my entire office knows this. In fact, when I was leaving as well, I had the Benelli parked in our company parking lot. And the day I was leaving, I went down to the parking lot to start the bike up, and there was a note left. Someone printed out a note saying, have a safe ride to Pondicherry. It's a jungle on the way there. Smiley face. So a lot of people from work support what I do. My family is very supportive, so although they are busy with their own lives in their own fields,
yeah.
I think they still take time out to watch my content, and they give me their suggestions or their feedback every now and then. So your best critics are the people who would otherwise normally say, hey, it's great, but then you're not improving if people just keep on telling them that what you're doing is great. Like, we need that difference. So people who know you inside out are the best. So I get a lot of support from family, friends and from work to be able to do this. While my uploads are few and far between, I think for me, I'd rather put out content which is well edited and which I feel proud about if I were to watch a few years later than just put out random videos every now. Because that was good when I was just starting up. But I realized that there's a lot more responsibility on my shoulders, a lot more people to talk to me. When I meet these kids on the road who say that they are my subscribers, I'm shocked. Because that's something which will help change the way people ride in the future, right?
Yeah.
We are doomed at least on the road. I think at least our future generation
are safe. Yeah. So it's.
You had a question?
That's it about today's vlog. If you guys have enjoyed this vlog, do hit the like and the subscribe button down below. Thanks for watching and I'll catch you with the next one. Wait a second. Forgot to tell one thing. It's a jungle out there. Be careful, ride safe.